Today we're not talking about money, but we are talking about self-made millionaires. I'm sure you've heard my story before that I thought I was going to be an overnight business success, and the reality is it doesn't work that way. So I didn't become a self-made millionaire overnight, but I have interviewed over 100 self-made millionaires, and this is what I've learned. In this video, I'm going to share with you the biggest myth that these self-made millionaires made me aware of. We'll also talk about what it looks like to have it all on your shoulders. And I'm going to share with you the best advice I've ever gotten. So first, self-made. It means that they have done the work themselves to become successful. It means that we haven't worked with inherited money, that we haven't worked with loans necessarily, that we haven't been just gifted all of the money. The fact that these people have worked their way to creating their success, that is what it means to be self-made. So that is really inspiring if you think about it, that anyone has the capability of becoming a self-made success story. All they have to do is put their head down to it, think about creating it, and then actually take action to doing it. You can't just sit back and watch a ton of YouTube videos about becoming a self-made millionaire. You actually have to go take the steps to do it. And that is the biggest advice that these self-made millionaires brought to my attention, is that you have to start taking action. You have to do the work. Yes, eventually you will start to build your team, you'll hire on more people, you can outsource certain tasks, but ultimately you need to stop thinking about it and start taking action. And the simplest action that you can take right now is to hit the subscribe button. Join us on the channel. Every week, new videos. We talk about influence, authority, but ultimately making more money online. Join us. When you're a self-made millionaire, when you're a self-made success story, you sometimes feel like you have everything on your shoulders. You have the weight of your entire company, your entire brand, your entire message is resting on your shoulders. You're going to take on all of the good and all of the bad. So you need to build strong shoulders in order to do that. You need to keep your mind and your body in check. But ultimately, as an entrepreneur, you need to tune your mind into becoming a problem solver. So when you start looking out at the world, you start looking out at your customers, not only are you getting to know them to build trust with them, but you're also getting to know them so that you can create solutions to their problems. When you position yourself as the solver of your customers' problems, the person with the best option for them, not only are you the best option, but actually, because you've listened to them so intently, you are the only person who has the solution to their problems. That's when you're going to start seeing huge jumps in your success, because it's not about you. You are running a machine. The machine cranks out results. That's the important thing that you need to remember when you are on your entrepreneurial journey. Let me know in the comments below what kind of problems you solve for your people. I'm curious to see about who's in our community and what you guys are building. And if you're not yet there, you don't necessarily have your business yet, tell us about what kinds of problems you think you could solve with your powers and your superpowers and your skills. Let us know in the comments below. The best piece of advice I ever got from these entrepreneurs was just keep going. Just keep going. Every morning you get up, you go through your routine, you keep moving. Every night before bed, you write down what your next tasks are going to be. You just keep moving. If you have an obstacle in your way, if a customer says no, you're on a sales call and they just keep saying no, or you're not getting booked in the places you want to get booked, just keep going. Because when you build that consistency, when you show up, maybe at first only for a couple of people, but eventually that consistency is going to pay off. You're going to start gathering more people. You're going to show your consistency shows the algorithms that you're good, and you're going to start creating content so the algorithms are going to like you more. You're going to start showing your customers that you can solve problems. They're going to start building trust with you. You're going to start showing your message showing that your message works in the best of times and when times are tough. So, my friends, just keep moving. You got this. I love it. And I want to see you guys as part of the official Visibility Hackers movement. So what you're going to do is head down to visibilityhacking.com, click the link at the very top of the page, and become an official Visibility Hacker. Join us in the group. We've got tons of great people, tons of great stuff happening, and I want to see you guys along for the journey. So while you do that, also check out one of these great videos, and I will see you in our next one. Until then, remember, I love you. Be excellent to each other.